stomach, and then we finish it. I want to emphasize on certain points in there. And thus, after having explained the principle of the makifim, there is makif haklol. Makif haklol means the overall makif, a makif that does not have any identifying qualities. It's not a makif for seichel, a makif for midas, a makif for mashmashov and divamaisa. It's not a makif of any kind of a focus. Makif haklol. And the highest makif haklol is lifnei hatzimtzum. Atzmus itself has decided to create the world, and therefore it identifies the world from an Atzmus perspective. In which everything is included, provided everything is welcome, everything has a place. The extremely dramatic statement in this, everything has a place, that even clippers have a place. Everything is getting its right of being. Yifnei hatzimtzum means that there is not any kind of worldly identification. It is all from the etzem itself. We spoke about etzem, and I'd like to eventually to review it. The principle of etzem is that this is a self-standing reality. Has no limits as to what it can relate to. This is what's known as the ego hagodu. Okay. So there is a tzimzum tzimtzum, and then there is makif hakloli after the tzimtzum. After that, there was an intent for world, which means this is specifically to give support to world, to say, also everything in the world. So therefore, this is also a makif haklodi. This is a makif haklodi that already identifies the intent of world. So therefore, what the Rebbe says is, we must understand the difference legabe ho'ilomis relative to worlds. What's the difference in the Gabi Ha'ilonis? In and in themselves, this makif and that makif, we can speak about the difference, as we spoke about with the Ibrahim Shorim we had. We can speak about the difference. But how is this difference affect world? World takes the makif, has the makif on both levels. How is these two levels affect the world differently? And again, as we pointed out, the reason we're asking the question is not because we have a specific reason that says there is difference and the amount of identity. The Vada, for surely, without even focusing on identifying it. Surely, yesh hefle, surely there's a difference. Bein makif hakloli d'tira tato, v'makif hakloli d'tira ilo. Surely there's a difference between the makif hakloli of tira tato. Again, this is relative how it affects the world. Surely there's a difference. Why surely there is a difference? The Rebbe says the Hagam Zishneihem Makifim Klolus Hashtalshut Mahashvot. although both are makif, embrace the entire Hishtalshus, closer Hishtalshus. You say the closer Hishtalshus means the Hishtalshus not by having identified what is contained therein, but the entire principle of Hishtalshus. And what is the principle of Hishtalshus? What is Hishtalshus? Hishtalshus means the moral of the process, how one thing causes another. One world brings about another. From Atzilus comes Bria, from Bria comes Yetzira, and so forth. From Chochma comes Bina, from Bina comes Das, and then Midas. This is Hishtalshus. This is a process within a worldly reality. Both my keeping encompass and embrace the closest Hishtalshus, the entire principle of Hishtalshus. And as we already discussed it yesterday, in a couple of days, a couple of times, that the makif contains in its principle all aspects of that world that will surface in the world. Just as when Hashem said, let there be living beast, chayas ha'aretz, and it does not specify what chayas ha'aretz are. And from this were created all the various species of chayas. Because from this vantage point, all chayas are included. All chayas are of equal status. They all have a source, and we can relate to it. He can relate and give chayas to all of them, even though they're very different. So when it comes to in a world, in environment, so we have people walking dogs, but you're not going to have people walking horses or donkeys. You walk the horses because the horses need to be walked once a day, whatever it is, but not for their personal friendship, their personal company. So there's a difference. But when it comes to the makif hakol, they're all included, you're all included. They're all chayas. And that's what it says. It has to be taken for granted. We have to understand in our seichel. Surely the difference between makif hakol, yedir tator, and makif hakol, yedir tator. The hagam, sheshneya makifim kol, yishtasun bashwa. For although they both encompass the entire Hishtalshus b'ashvo in total equality. Everything has a place there. Mikol mokom, but yet still, there has to be a sensitive difference. Tzorich leima. We have to recognize that here tato hu b'vchinas kiruv yesh. That here Tatori is in a closer sense to world than the here Tatori, the interior world. Both of them provide, both Madrigas of the here of Makif Elyon, provide the environment, the right of being for closer Hishtalshus. But here Tato, okay. is mechinas kiruv yaser, as a greater closeness, a greater identity with a personal identity with the world. We already have given the marshal for this. When we call Malkoin, but yet still, even though that we, from an overall perspective, recognize that Tira Tato is called closer to Tira to work, to start from the Tira Tato. We call Malkoin still, Gam Bechinas Hamakim the Tira Tato. Also, and even the Bechinas Hamakim, this aspect of the Makif of Tira Tato. Let me again focus in on the word Bechinas. We translate Bechinas aspect for lack of a more direct translation. And I explained the word Bechina, that is a word we use in Chassidus all the time. The word bechinot by translation means a test. When is test germane? When is test employed? Test is employed when on the surface you cannot tell the difference between one and another. Therefore, you have to put it to some kind of a test that each responds to circumstances in a different way. And that tells you what is internally contained in this thing. In our situation, in our world, you test blood for its content. Even though by observation there's no difference, but you test it to see when there is a contaminant in the blood. Could be a contaminant, a fatal contaminant, and you can't tell. But this is known only by Bechina, by testing. What is the phenomenon of testing? How does test reveal it? Testing is you inject into the blood something that will be affected directly by any kind of negative contact. Just as in a school, in a class, he's an expert of class. If I'm going to tell me, have you had a class? People, children are learning a long period of time. They're learning whatever it is, mathematics, history, how the Chumash, whatever it is. And they are doing well. They know their stuff. When do you, from a responsible perspective, if you really want, what did they learn today? You have to put it to them in a very specific, in-your-face question. This test challenges the child to answer the question not just from what he remembers from learning, but something that he really identifies with, in his seichel. This is what the test is. This is why the test is sometimes a little convoluted, a little complex. So even though he gets into convoluted roadways, he finds his way. That's a test. Am I right?
Test is an assessment. to see the degree of knowledge obtained or skill. You could test either skill or a piece of knowledge.
He knows everything. Put him to a test. That's when you know how deeply and clearly he knows.
And there are different degrees.
Huh?
And obviously,
yeah,
there are different
degrees. Yeah, of course. Then there are different ages. And this is the pshat. Bechinas ha-makiv letihiri lo, and bechinas ma-makiv letihiri tato. Makiv is makiv. But when you put it to the test, to, so to speak, to the effect, practical effect, how one affects the other, one is affected by the other, by the world, one is not. This is where the difference surfaces. So he says, even though makifim amakif clothes and stalsels, the entire stalsels b'hashvoa equally, everything in his stalsels has a place and accepted in this makifim. But still, it is relative and recognizable that here tato is with greater closeness to world than here ilo. Closeness to world means that within tira tato you can identify worldly qualities more readily than in tira ilo. Even tira ilo is also supporting it. Mekomokom b'yad still gar b'chinas ha-makif b'tira ilo. Also the b'china ha-makif, we can't tell superficially, but the b'china ha-makif, if you get down into the nitty-gritty of the makif b'tira ilo, b'hech lech loimer, it is imperative, we must say, shepeil b'ilogis, that this makif b'tira ilo also poil b'ilo means has an effect on the world. Let us put it in our environment. In a school, you have a teacher. You have a teacher's helper, the counselor in the class. Then you have a teacher. Then you have a principal for various departments. Then you have the general principal. Then you have the director. Then you have the board and the president and so forth. Each one is a different level in terms of their relationship to the school. They're very much involved in so forth. But each level that we mentioned is more remotely involved. Despite the fact that they're remotely involved, if they're worthy of their name, of their term, of their boy, and they really are doing their job, they are affected by the success and has its own failure of the school. And therefore, if you have a school that has a teacher and all the other ranks, but a president, the president is no president, is no chairman of the board, is the school being going to be affected by that or not? The school is definitely going to be affected. Why? How? Even the teacher and the principal and all they have to have an authority to which they have to answer that is above the whole frame. And if they don't have that, laxity sets in, and it loses the focus of the purpose. And I have an expert here who shakes his head and says, yes. So therefore, makim tiri lo, behechrech loy mashepoyel beilomis. If the beam, all the makifim, but married to the law would be lacking, the worlds would be lacking. Shehare, for behold, who bivchinas makif al koponim elohilos. He has the aspect of makif al koponim. Al koponim means at the minimum, even though it's in a remote way, but there is a makif support from this lofty place into the to the world. Just one second. I just thought of an important way to focus in on this. Just one second. I'm sorry, Yoshua. To us, this is of extreme importance. The Rambam says, the principle of all principles is to know that is a first being. What's so important about a first being? Ultimately, you live not with the first being, you live in the world that was created at your level. And the Rambam says that this is in Torah that you say this is the foundation of all foundations. This is what makes everything stand. A human being, this is something that's extremely important. It strikes me from time to time. You may learn, you have Shulchan Aruch, and you have Halacha, and you have Gemara, and you have Chassidus, you have all kinds of different things. If Rachman Islam, you lose sight of these motivations standing in front of you, that the Alter Rebbe says, "Vini Hashem oimed olav," Hashem standing over him, "umrei kol ha'otzkim, umabid olav," and he's looking at him, when he's doing his service, koroi. If you lack this sense, you lose the reality of your own life. This makif, a dear law, the most remotest thing, he's looking at you from a distance. That observation from a distance is what makes you a real. Yes, Shlomo. Shlomo Bambe.
Yeah, yeah. What this makif, the dear law is makif oilam, is if it's before the tzimtzum, then there's not an oilam.
Yeah, well, this we explained last few days.
Also with the house and the furniture.
Yeah.
But how's it been dimensional if it's...
We said we use the human being as the means of which to understand this. The Rebbe created the human being after all the whole world was in place. And he said, let us make men with Samarikin Musayim. This is Makim HaKolonim. But so many people say, he's been our form and not like in our likeness. He's not part of the world altogether. So how does he belong in this world? So what's the point of creating him? We're creating a world. We're not creating, revealing things for the sake of revealing, but revealing the world. Not so, let's make me. make me create something new that is not there. And the Rebbe says, no, we have to create Mitzalmenik is the same. He says clearly, he's not going to be a worldly creature. I've discussed with him in a few last few days. A human being that is not a worldly creature, doesn't belong in the world. But he, but in the world, needs such an entity. So that the world will have the right to be called the world. And that truth, this inyan, goes all the way up to lifnei hatzimtzum. Because the creation of world, even though it was decided on, you know, when the Rebbe decided to create the world, but the principle of creation, the principle of revelation, this is, you could say, with a little bit of a qualifier, inherent in its. I will say all the time, what illuminates the world, what makes day, not the light of the sun, but the sun itself. That the sun, and the sun is is not light at all. The sun is a standalone ball from changes and vibrations without any change. Does the sun relate to the world or it doesn't relate to the world? It's in its own circle, it's in all about. So that's a befeilish. The shemesh mem shelus banyan. It is like a supreme being. It's not slavish in the world. And it rules the world, but it's memshalas, it rules the world. So therefore its relationship to the world is true. In what way? That it rules the world. It transforms the world into its image. And as we explained many times, this thing that Shemesh Memshel Bayim transforms the world in its image, it's not because it transforms the world. It transforms everything in its wake, in its environment, becomes Shemesh. So it has an effect on world, even though this is beyond world. The Shemesh, as I said, you see this, the Shemesh is not affected whether its light reaches the earth or that there are clouds that prevent the light to reach the earth. And the truth is, this is a little bit more, but you understand. The truth is, there are clouds, and it's a very clouded day, and there's a heavy rain. There's a difference whether this is daytime or nighttime. Even though, practically speaking, you say, what's the difference? What's the difference? The king of the world is the sun still. The world belongs to it by daytime. All right. Does that answer your question, Shlomo?
Yes, but I still.
Because everything that was created is recognized from all the way back to the source of sources. This is that Be'echa Shepeil Be'ilom, it has an effect on the Elom, as we gave the Musholim of the Chamber of the Word and so on. Sha'arei Be'echin is Makif Al Kaponim Al Elom. It has the aspect of Makif, Be'echin is Makif. You can test for it. And what's the test? If it were not there, it would be a different world. If there was no chairman of the board, the school would be different. Even though he has hardly any input into the running of the school. So it's a matter of law. V'im kein, two lines from the end of that section. V'im kein, and therefore, behechrach lo imer. We must recognize, it's imperative for us to say, shepoel gamkin bo elomis, that it has, it's a makif for elomis, and therefore it has some kind of effect on the world. But tzorich lehovin, okay, the Rebbe there spares no challenge. But tzorich lehovin, we need to understand. Mahu ha-heflish b'neya. What's the difference between these two makif? Makif ha-kloli nifnei ha-tzimtzum. Makif ha-kloli after ha-tzimtzum. They're the law and the other two. Metzorich lo-hobin. We know there is Chochmah and Bina, and above Chochmah there is Rotzen and Noinag and so forth. It says Tzorich Lehovin means it is necessary to identify this difference at the Bina level. Something that we can identify and point to. Ha'hefresh b'neihem, the difference between these two makif. The gam, and also, we need to understand mahu piyoloshem b'hoyilomeis. What is their effect on the world? Again, back to our mushroom. The chairman of the board has an effect, but you're saying, yeah, he has an effect. But mahu, what is the effect? So chalomim means we have to identify and say what is the difference. Why is it that there's no chairman, but the school is not the same? What's different?